Today we're going to look at how you can take your employee data that's already in an Excel format and transform that into a template that you can use to actually generate an organizational chart using a free Visio add-in from within Excel. Now you do have to have a work or school Microsoft 365 account in order to use this free add-in, but if you do, it is a great way to quickly create a chart out of the data that you already have in Excel. We're also going to take a look at some cool Excel tricks on how to transform your data. So if you have a report in one format and you want to transform and crosswalk that into another template in another format, I'm going to show you some tricks and formulas and ways to do that quickly and easily. Let's take a look. Here we are in our Excel database, and we have several columns of data that we're going to transform into an org chart. The first thing I'm going to do is make sure that I'm signed in with my work or school Microsoft 365 account. So if you happen to have a personal one and a work one, make sure that you're signed in with your work account. The next thing I'm going to do is a little bit of a best practice. Whenever I run a report out of an HR system and I'm going to be working with that data, I like to make a copy of it just so I can refer back to it. So I'm going to come down here and I'm going to right click at the bottom of the tab. I'm going to select move or copy, and then we are going to say move to end and check the box that says create a copy and click OK. And so here at the end, we have employee database 2. And this is just so that we can refer back to this in case we need to, because we're going to be manipulating the data on that other tab. All right, now I'm going to click on a new tab. And I'm going to come up to insert. And I'm going to click on get add-ins. The Visio add-in is a popular one, so it may show up right here for you. If it doesn't, you can go ahead and just click on Visio and hit enter to search for it. And then click on add. There's a message that will pop up that you do have to have a license for Visio in order to edit within Visio, but you can use this add-in for free in Excel as long as you're logged in with your work or school Microsoft account. So I'm going to click continue. And the data visualizer window pops up, and from here I can click on org charts, and it's going to give me some different designs of org charts that I can choose from. I'm going to click the vertical one, which is a pretty standard one, and click create. So you can see that this tab is now populated with a sample table of employee information and the org chart, the resulting org chart over here based on what we selected. So we are going to use our data and add it to this table, and then we're going to create our own org chart using this format. So notice that up here at the top we have employee ID, name, title, manager ID, and role type. So what I've done is I have copied, hit Control C, and I created a tab called Mapped Data, and I pasted those headers over here. So this is the format that I'm going to want to transform my employee report into so that I can paste it onto the tab and use the Visio visualizer to convert that into the org chart. So now I'm going to click on my employee database. So from here, I know that based on the columns of data that I need to put into that template, that I'm going to need a full name column that has first name space last name of the employee. And then I'm also going to need to map the employee ID number of the manager for each one of those employees in order for this to work. And then I also need to crosswalk the field that I use for work type, or maybe use manager structure or a similar type of field to indicate what type of manager or structure the employee works in. I need to map that to role type, which are certain role types that are available on that template. So here's what we're going to do first. In the full name column, I want to put together the first name space last name. So I'm going to select my first cell and I'm going to hit equals, and I'm going to select the first name cell, and then I'm going to hit the ampersand symbol, quotes, space, quotes, ampersand, and then the last name column, and then hit enter. And that puts the first and last name together. I'm going to select that cell and I'm going to put my cursor in the bottom right corner where it turns into a crosshairs, and I'm going to double click to copy that formula down. And this copies the formula down all the way to the end of my spreadsheet. And now what I want to do is, this has the formula in the column, but I just want the text of the name. So what I'm going to do is keep all of it selected, and I'm going to right click and select copy, and then right click and select Paste Special and select Values. And now in those fields is just the text name and not the formula that we just used. So the next thing I want to do is populate this manager ID column with the employee ID number of whoever the manager is, right? So for example, we have Jeff Bingham and he reports to Burton Guster. So we can see Burton Guster's employee ID number is 100. So here in this cell, I want to populate this with 100 with Burton Guster's employee ID number. So in order to do this, I'm going to use an XLOOKUP formula and I'm going to use last names. This will work for me because I don't have any duplicate last names in my list of employee names. So here's how we're going to do this. I'm going to go ahead and delete this. I'm going to insert a column here. I'm going to right click and click on insert. So I have an extra column over here. And what I want to do is I want to separate out the last name and first name of this manager column because my report spit it out as last name, comma, first name. So I'm going to go up to the data tab. I'm going to highlight the column that I want to split out and I'm going to click on text to columns. I'm going to say delimited and then click next. And I'm going to select comma here because we want to separate anything after the comma. We want to put that first name into another column. So I'm going to click next and then I'm going to click finish. And we'll click OK. And this will move all of the first names into another column. So I actually don't need those. So I'm going to select that column, right click and delete it. So now I just have the manager last names. And now I'm going to use my XLOOKUP formula to match and find the employee ID number of those managers. So what I'm going to do is come over here and I'm going to select equals and I'm going to type XLOOKUP and then open parentheses. And then I'm going to select the value that I want to look up, which is going to be this column here. And then I'm going to hit comma. And then I want to look up in the array of the employee's last name. So I'm going to select that column and then I'm going to hit comma. And then I want it to return the employee ID. So I'm going to select that column. And now I'm going to close my parentheses and I'll hit enter. And the formula is going to add an at symbol here. And we just click yes. And then it adds that number there. So it's looking up to find Jeff Bingham's manager's employee ID number and so forth. So now all we have to do is again, bring our mouse down to the corner there where the crosshairs and double click and we copy that formula down. And so we can double check and make sure, you know, we see that Jen Barber's boss is last name Bartowski. So Bartowski's ID number is 103. And we see here that she reports to manager ID 103. So we need this in order for our org chart to pick up who reports to who and put people in the right boxes. So now what I want to do is select this column again, and I'm going to right click, I'm going to copy, and I'm going to right click and paste those values because I don't want the formula in there. I want the actual value of the employee ID number. So now we've got that. And that's ready to go. Now, the only other thing that we have to do now is fix the role type. We want to crosswalk those role types to our report where we have a manager work type. So I created a separate tab to show you all what we're doing here. And this is the role type and the options that are available when we inserted our Visio chart. I'm going to go back to that chart page. Notice here that if we click on the role type, there's a drop down and we've got executive, manager, position, assistant, staff, consultant, or vacancy. So these are going to display as different colors on the org chart based on the level of role that someone has. So we want to map our data into these role types. So let's go back to our crosswalk here. So these are the role types that I copied and pasted, and these are the work types that I just brought over from my report or from my HR system that I use that I run the report out of. And so I want to actually map these together so that executive maps one-to-one. So executive can map to executive, which is great. But maybe I want my vice president, director, manager, and supervisors to map all those to map to the manager role type. type. So in order to do that, I'm going to set up a quick nested if formula that will look at these values and map them to the correct role type over here that I want to display. And so I'm going to just show you, I've already filled this in, and so I'm just going to show you what it looks like. So we'll say if, and we select the cell of our work type. So if it's executive, and if this cell equals executive, we want the value to be returned as executive. So that's what this is saying here. But if that value is vice president, then we want it to return as manager. And if it's director, we want it to return as manager. If it's manager, return as manager. Supervisor, return as manager. Employee, return as staff. And then intern, return as assistant. And then we close all of our parentheses in order to make this nested if, the syntax correct on this. So now all we have to do is copy our formula here. I'm going to hit copy. And I'm going to come back into my employee database. And I'm going to select the column over here where I want this to work. And I'm going to hit Control V to paste the formula. Now, right here, I'm going to have to fix the column that it's looking at because I want it to look at column H. So I'm going to replace that on each of these. Okay, so now I've replaced that. Now I can copy this formula down by double clicking on the bottom right hand corner of that cell, copies the formula down. And we don't want the formula in there, but the values. So we're going to right click, copy, and then right click, paste special, and click on values. So now I'm going to go ahead and unhighlight those rows there just by going to the home tab and then coming to my formatting and just clicking no fill. So now we have all of the data that we want to put into the right template so that we can copy and paste this easily into create our org chart. So the first thing I want to do is copy the relevant columns into my mapped data field so that I have everything ready to copy and paste. So we know we're going to copy the employee ID number. So I'm going to select those, hit copy, Control C, and I'm going to paste that. We have name, title, and manager ID and role type. So I'm going to copy those and paste them on here as well. All right, now that we have our data completely formatted, now all we have to do is copy and paste this onto our new tab. Our new tab showed up as sheet 9 here. I'm going to double click to rename that, and I'm just going to name it org chart. All right, so let's take our mapped data. Let's copy everything. Select it all, hit Control C. Let's come over to our org chart tab, and I'm going to put my cursor underneath this table and hit Control V, and it's going to paste everything underneath the table here. I'm going to go ahead and delete the rows of sample data that were imported when we inserted this. I'm going to just select those and hit delete. And now all I have to do is come over here and hit refresh. Once our data's been refreshed, we can come up here and click on the three dots and we can say open in web. And here we have our org chart. We can come down and zoom in to make this a little bit larger so you can see it better. And we have options up here that we can actually export this to PDF. If we click on the three dots up here, we can download this as a PDF version, or we can even download as an image. So if we wanted to, we could select download as image. We can open up our download. And from here, if we want to right click, we can copy. And say we want to paste it into our PowerPoint presentation. We have a blank PowerPoint here where we want to put our org chart. We can just paste that and it will paste the image there for your PowerPoint presentation. I'm going to click on Close Designer tab. So there's different things that you can now do with this data that you can quickly generate this chart without having to draw out the chart. And you can, as long as you have the data template transformed, you can easily do this from your Excel data. One thing I recommend is doing this with smaller departments and breaking out your different departments so that the charts are easier to see, because the more data you try to generate, it's just going to be very, very small, and it may be difficult to view different formats if it's a lot of information. So I recommend doing your high level departments and going down a few levels within your org structure so that it's easy to read and understand. Now let's quickly go back to the Visio web version. Now, since we don't have an actual license to Visio, we're not able to make any edits. You'll get a warning if you do try to make edits in the browser or desktop version. It'll give you a little warning that a license is required. So you would have to have that license if you wanted to go in and make edits directly from within Visio on this chart. But let's go back to Excel real quick. The nice thing about this is if you do have someone else to add down here, you can easily add someone onto the table, and we can add that person's name here and hit enter. And then when we come over and refresh, I added someone else on the help desk, so we should see that pop up. All we have to do is hit the refresh button. It'll refresh your diagram, then you can regenerate that into the web view and see your updated chart. So it added that person on, and we can now go to the open in web. And we see our new employee down here. So likewise, you can manage your data table once you have this set up. If someone leaves, you can change it. You can delete their name, maybe put open position, and then change that to a vacancy. And then that will show up as a different color on the org chart to call that out. So it's a very nice way to quickly generate that org chart view from your employee data. If you found this video helpful, be sure and give it a thumbs up. To like it, you can subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Be sure and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.